Nice. Today we are going to have a closer look at the Open Pro in Copa. I'm very excited about this one. I was really hoping that they would release it, as I already have the standard black version, I have the titanium version, and now I finally also have the copper version. This is the Open 2 without laser, with the switch on the top. So also a very nice piece. For me, it was a bit too heavy to use it on a daily basis. I tried it, but after a few weeks, I just put it on the shelf to my copper flashlight collection because it's a very nice item to have. So I would say that we will unbox this beauty. I have already taken off the plastic film in which it is wrapped. So for the package, it is slightly different as the normal open, as you can see. Bigger package, it's a limited edition, so it's a bit nicer displayed. So it's a hard cardboard box with no special information on it, except for the serial number, so the 29 59, and you take it out. The normal Pro version comes in this small plastic box, which is also nice, but in my eyes, a bit of overkill because you don't need that much plastic and you will never use the box anyway. So, this one is airtight sealed, so that the copper will not start oxidating. And then we have spare refill, USB-C charging cable, and of course the manual, which we'll have a closer look later on. So now comes the final moment where I'm able to unbox it. I've already been playing with the idea the entire day, but I wanted to open it on camera. So, very nice finish. They gave it somehow a steel brush finish, which is nice to the clean finish of the Open 2. It's nice with the black. I also like the blue, but I think I prefer the black with the laser on top and the LED in the clip. So this is pretty nice. Before the first use, they indicate that you need to take off the little ball from the cap, so that that's to prevent the pen from drying out while it is stored. So it's like wax or plastic coating, I don't know what it is exactly. So to change the cartridge, you just unscrew here and then you can take it out. It comes standard with a black cartridge. I will see to get the blue refill because I prefer blue. So here you see the black oxide finishing. It's nicely greased. Threads run smoothly as we know it from Olight. And of course the nice bolt action mechanism, which I really like. Then you can unscrew the top with the USB-C port, and here you have the button with whom you can also operate the light if you don't want it with the pen. So you can use both parts separately from each other. However, in my eyes, it's the best if you just keep them together. User interface is pretty simple. short click turns the light on, and then if you keep the button pressed, it will cycle through the four different output modes with a maximum of 120 lumens. Single click back up turns the light off. To activate the laser pointer, you need to press the button for a long time, and then you have a laser pointer. Single click to turn it off again. The clip is nice, but in my opinion a bit too sturdy. On my titanium version I slightly bend it up because I always carry it in my pocket, so it's easier to get it in and out. So the engravings are nicely done, as you can see. On top you have the serial number, which is nicer on the titanium version than on the copper version. As you can see, the QR code is not really nice engraved here, but that's not the most important. I really like this brushed finish. Compared to the Open 2, it has become thinner. As you can see, this one is much thicker, so for daily writing this one is really too heavy, but this one is quite okay. If you need to write a lot, I prefer to use the titanium or the aluminium version, but this one is still really nice because it has a decent weight, so if you want to sign a big contract or so, it's always cool to have a badass pen. So I took out the manual, which comes in all the different important languages. You can see the four different output modes. We have high, 120 lumens for 23 minutes, and then it only has 10% of the 120 lumen, so 12 lumen left for about 5 minutes, with the medium mode with 60 lumen for 40 minutes, and then it dims down to 17%, and it will continue for 5 minutes. 20 lumen mode will run at 100% for 2 hours, and the 5 lumen mode will run with 100% for 8 hours. Maximum beam distance 14 meters, so not much, but still plenty enough for such a small light. 49 candela peak beam intensity. The dimensions, 153 millimeters of length, diameter 12.7 millimeters, and the weight is 72.3 grams. It's a green laser with a max output of 0.39 milliwatt, so class 1 laser, maximum runtime 4 hours 30 minutes, so that should be plenty. The laser wavelength is 508 to 530 nanometers. I personally would prefer a stronger laser, but this is due to regulations. They are not able to install anything bigger. Then we have the different descriptions. I already showed you how to assemble and disassemble it. Charging will take about 55 minutes, 4.2 volt, 200 milliamp constant current. And I will show you how the charging is running later. An important thing I forgot to tell you is that if you want to access direct turbo, you need to quick press twice the button up, so, and then you are directly in the turbo mode. Otherwise it will always start in the lowest mode and then cycle through the modes from moon to high. Unfortunately, in my eyes, it's no moon mode. 5 lumen is way above a moon mode. It's a low mode, that's nice, but in my eyes it should have 1 lumen if you really want a moon mode. So I would like to show you a little weight comparison between the different Open models. So we have the copper version, as they say, with 72.9 grams. They indicate 72.3, so that's really accurate. Then we have the titanium with 43, which is quite a difference. The aluminium version with 34, so this one is even lighter for all the people that want it light. It's really important to take the aluminium version. If we now take the Open 2, 76, so it's only 4 grams or 3 grams heavier than the Pro version, but because it is thicker, you have the impression that it is heavier. So this one is better for writing than this one. So let's have a quick look at the charging function. So as already shown, disassemble it. And I have my small power bank. As you can see, red light is glowing. And as long as this one is turned on, it means it's charging. After it's fully charged, the light will turn off after 60 seconds, so you know that it is fully charged. So I will charge it up now and then do a quick test in the Ulbricht ball, how much lumens we are getting out of the different modes, and then we are going to head out for the beam shots. Well, guys, we're outside now with the Open Pro in the lowest mode, which is indicated with 5 lumens in the manual. As you can see, it still produces some decent light. In my Ulbricht ball, I measured 2.5 lumen, which personally I prefer, because I would even have preferred a lower moon mode than 2.5 lumen, because in the night you don't need much to preserve the night view. Here we have the 20 lumen mode, which is measured with 16 lumen in my Ulbricht ball. As you can see, now you can already recognize my chairs and table in the background. I will now initiate the 60 lumen mode, which I measured with 55 lumen, so this is pretty bright already. And then we have the 120 lumen mode, which really enlightens the garden already for such a small LED. And here I measured 110 lumen, so the outputs that they indicate are pretty accurate. I will now switch over to the laser. As you can see, it is working just fine for presentations and so on, so it's bright enough. The only thing I really don't like is that the beam of the laser is not really good looking. As you can see, it's not a sharp beam. Now, as soon as you have the slightest dirt on the lens, it's like this. I will clean it off now. And then you always have these artifacts inside the beam, so personally I don't like that. In a pen with this price range, I think they could improve a little bit on the laser here. For the rest, I really like the pen. I use the titanium version on a daily basis as an EDC, so I really hope that you liked this review. If so, please make sure to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would also really appreciate if you would follow my Instagram channel. I will now just show you a 5-watt laser. So the Open has 0.39 milliwatt, and this is a 5 milliwatt laser. So this is not allowed. It is really powerful. Maybe in a future version, Olight will install a little bit more power in the laser, but the main thing, as I said, is really that they should get a cleaner beam from the laser. So stay tuned for future reviews and see you soon, guys. Bye bye.